Now that you know the basics for microcontrollers input output, let's take a quick look at how to make it communicate with other more complex devices. One of the oldest and simplest protocol is the Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter, abbreviated as UART, and also known as RS-232. The transmission only uses one wire where a device transmits and another to receive the data. Two devices only need to agree on which baud to use and share the same ground to make sure that they read the right voltage values. The transmitter keeps a high level when it is nothing to send. Then it emits a low level value for one baud, followed by the 8-bit data, and then at least one baud of high bit. The receiver samples the signals at A or 16 times the baud and waits for the beginning of a transmission. Then it stores the 8-bit in a shift register, and finally it copies the byte in the internal register. While this protocol is very easy to implement and use, it is quite inefficient from a speed point of view, because the reader needs to read at a fraction of its clock to accommodate the supersampling of the signal. Serial Peripheral Device, abbreviated SP, is a faster protocol where the sender and the receiver share a clock signal. Adding this extra cable, the two devices can transmit data at the same frequency of the internal clocks. SP also standardizes the use of two different cables for the transmission, so that the master can send to the slave at the same time as the slave can transmit to the master. There is also an extra cable that the master can use to enable or disable the slave, but such cable is not necessary if the master only drives one slave. With multi-slave configurations, the slave select connections are inevitable, but they can be reduced to one in a disjointed configuration, at the cost of extra software cycles and transmission latency. Another popular microcontroller protocol is the Inter-Integrated Circuit, abbreviated I2C. It only uses three wires and supports multi-master, multi-slave. But it implements a packet switch protocol, which is rather computational heavy. A different protocol that can be implemented inside the microcontroller is the more familiar Universal Serial Bus. USB has many classes of devices that you can import in your project to implement keyboard, mouses, joysticks, MIDI controllers, mass storage devices, and many more. Some microcontrollers offer a USB port that you can connect to the computer. But if they don't have one, you can easily cut an old USB cable and connect its four wires to VCC, ground, and two digital pins. Finally, let's take a look at the most common ways to make your microcontroller into one of the things in the Internet of Things. Many microcontrollers come with a Wi-Fi chip already, and they offer APIs to receive and send TCP IP packets. Other models have a Bluetooth Low Energy interface which uses a lot less power, but the BLE software stack may use quite a lot of space in the RAM. Finally, not all the things in the Internet of Things need to be portable. If your device is fixed, probably an Ethernet connection will work just fine, and as a bonus, you can use the power over Ethernet to avoid using batteries or external power sources.